AMD Ryzen processors are known for their high performance and their power efficiency, which leads to a cool and quiet computer. But a cool and quiet computer requires effective cooling. Now, it starts with the cooler you put on the processor. In every second-gen AMD Ryzen desktop processor box, there is a cooler that we provide. This one comes with the AMD Ryzen 7 2700X, and there are other models for other AMD Ryzen CPUs. Now, there are also a massive market of aftermarket coolers, which are even more powerful than this. Some of them use fans in tower configurations or downdraft configurations like this heatsink you see here, but there are also water cooling units which pump a liquid through a series of tubes, radiators, and pumps, which are oftentimes even more effective at cooling the processor than an air cooling unit. Regardless of what you choose, you want to make sure that the thermal capacity of your heatsink, often rated in watts, such as 95 watts or 140 watts, is enough for your CPU. And it's a good idea generally to have more cooling capacity than you need. So if, for example, you have a 95 watt CPU, a middle of the road, a 140 watt cooler would be more than enough and help you get the cool and quiet computer that you're looking for. And those wattage specifications, or that 140 watts or 95 watts, is almost always listed on the specifications for the cooler. Next thing you need to know when taking a cooler off of a Ryzen CPU, and let's for example say that this cooler right here is installed on our processor, it's good to give the heatsink a little twist before pulling up. That's important because the thermal paste on the bottom of the heatsink can start to cure to the top of the CPU. And that's good because that helps heat come out of the processor and into the heatsink, but it makes the material a little stiff. So you want to give it that little wiggle just to break the seal before pulling the heatsink off the processor, and that can help you remove your heatsink safely and securely from your AMD Ryzen CPU. The last thing you'll want to keep in mind is effective cooling in your PC. It is not enough to have one fan in your computer case. You'll want to have a few. Generally, people intake air through the front of the case and exhaust air out the back of the case, but some enthusiast PC chassis take air in through the front and exhaust out the top. Really, the point is that you want to have an effective amount of airflow through your PC so there are no dead zones that can just collect heat and make your processor run hotter, which adds noise and subtracts performance from you. Long story short, make sure you have a quality cooler installed on the PC, starting with the one that we provide you in the box, but there are upgrades from there, and make sure you have nice airflow throughout your chassis with multiple fans.